reactions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Denver Broncos and the Miami Dolphins. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Start this drive in the air. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid gain.
They'll come up now second and four from the 31. A first carry now for Kareem Hunt, and he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32.
But when you go from second and four to third and three, that just tells you who won that battle on the last play, huh?
Yeah, first round went to the offense, second round the defense. Third play of this opening drive as they're looking at a third and three.
Hey, Delta!
Taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Well, they were in search of a short gain on third down, and they wind up nabbing over 20 yards.
First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
Set, ready. So a first and 10 now in Denver territory at the 47. They'll set up a throw. And he will find his man on the outside. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. A gain of six there on first.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
Second and four. And nearly an interception here on their opening drive. But instead, third down.
Well, it doesn't take any great analysis. No jokes, partner, okay? All right, on this one. But we just know that we're going to see this as the game moves forward. There's going to be two guys on him on just about every snap.
It's kind of a dare to throw his way, but they have to keep throwing his way.
The benefits could be great. You throw it to a great receiver, he could come down with it anyway.
Play him.
He'll look to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Fletcher Cox, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number seven for him on the year.
Now, that was just absolute perfect man coverage. Nowhere for them to go with the football led to a sack, and that's really difficult to do in today's NFL with all these gazelles running around that you're trying to cover in the secondary.
Lock and the Broncos going to come up first and 10 at the 20.
Check, check, 6-6, pull it high. Go, go. Deep river.
On first down, Lock. Man open, he's got it complete to Cortland Sutton.
Here we go.
A good pickup there, 21 yards.
A gain of 21 yards. First down.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Now the first carry here for Phillip Lindsay. And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored gives yourself, you give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
Check 31, check 31. Check, check. Lucky, lucky, lucky.
On second down and 4. Lock. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
On the ready. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. Faking the give to Lindsay. Here's Locke. Throws right side, and that's complete. Denver has a first down on the 15-yard play. So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 45-yard line. On first and 10, it's Lindsay. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. We should mention, to go along with a great game he had last week, he was rightfully named AFC Offensive Player of the Week.
And he shares that with his offensive line, the tight end, his fullback. He's looking for more and more of that in this game.
First carry of the game here for Royce Freeman. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. 2 yards, good enough for a first. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Lock now on first down. And he's going to have the hook up to Sutton. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. That one good for 13 and a Denver first down. This is Freeman on first and 10. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. That one going for a gain of 11 and a Bronco first down. Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script. You go through your play calling. You go through all the stuff and establish things. And it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
On first down, Lindsay. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. That loss of 3, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's second and 13. On second down, here's Locke. And that is caught. Touchdown, Denver. Noah Fant, his first touchdown on the year, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. McManus's point after is good, and that makes the score 7-0. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them they control your fate. leverage guys, win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25.
You don't want none, baby. You don't want none.
Hey. Second and 10. He finds Taylor, complete. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
Ready up.
They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at third down here. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Ready, break.
They'll drop the throw. Caught by the tight end Ertz. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. 17 yards for the Dolphins there as they've got themselves a first down. They'll run on first down. Evans. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Another example right there how this defense really is winning the entire game at the point of attack.
Yeah, right there at the line of scrimmage because they are dominating it. It allows their interior guys to get upfield and spill into the backfield. So how are you going to combat that? You know, people say bring in your tight end, keep him in. Your running backs, they have to step forward. Bottom line, your offensive line has to block them first to give yourself a chance.
52 is the mic right here over there, right? 52 is the mic. Who that? Who that?
The Dolphins going to take their second timeout. So as they take it over, we step aside.
Set, ready? 15, line. 15, line. 61, matchbox, lights.
Four yards on the pickup there, and now they're left with a third and 8.
Not your conventional play call, but that's okay. You probe the defense a little bit with some of everything in your playbook. That way they have to account for everything as the game moves on.
The Dolphins on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and 8.
Check 52. Kill, kill, kill.
They'll look to throw. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
And this one hits at the one, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They have to be thrilled with that first drive. They got them the touchdown. Now they'll be looking to make it a 2-score advantage here on the road.
And you know they spent all week in practice, in meetings, talking about taking an early advantage. Being the road team, going up a score, that takes the crowd out of the game and puts some doubt in the minds of their opponents.
They run on first down, but it only produces a gain of 2. It's second down now. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. From the 22, here's second and 8. Now Locke throwing on second down. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Going with a dime look on defense. Two extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That's allowed them to disrupt the play.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves them staring up here at a third and eight. Throwing his lock on third down. He's got a man. It's Sutton that's complete. Now he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. Give him 22 yards, and that's also where they snapped it from, the 22.
54's Mike. Check, check. Watch 54. Watch 54. Here we go. Let's bring it. Let's go. Let's bring it. Let's bring it. Check, 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 check.
22 Jets Bombers. 22 Jets Bombers.
54.
On first and 10, here's Locke. Got a man open, it's Sutton. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 18 big yards on that one, and a Denver first.
A gain of 18 on the play. First down.
Ready, ready.
So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 38. From the gun, it's a run for Freeman. Takes this to the 32, maybe the 31, and then the defense rallying quickly after that broken tackle. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
Brings up second and four at the 32-yard line.
The last run got six, now second and four. Second down, a run with Lindsey. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line.
Count me as a little bit surprised by what we just saw there because this has been a pretty long drive. And normally you think that wears down a defense. In this case, looked like the offensive line let him down a little bit.
Yeah, allowed the penetration and the ability to stuff him for a loss.
Ready.
Yeah, the Dolphins beef up the secondary here as they look to stop him on third down. From the gun on third down, Locke. He completes this to Sutton. They stop him for only three that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from the first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. They've had it twice. They've punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all, and let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice, so they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one. The last run got nine. That leaves them with second and a yard. 2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. Hey, reminder, coming up at halftime, we'll send you up to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman is there, and he'll have stats and scores from a busy Sunday in the NFL.
Go!
They'll run with Hunt on second down. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down. Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs or putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game, and that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
60 or
54.
So don't say nothing.
They'll go to the air here and two. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Here's Matt Hawk now as he's on to punt for Miami. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And a great job here. This is going to turn out to be a beauty. This is marked down at about the 3-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. The drive will commence with a run by Lindsey. And he's able to get this across the 10 before being taken down. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Broncos first down. Block now on first down. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 15. And they'll have a short field to work with inside the 15 at the 13-yard line. Backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. Now this time he'll look to throw. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining.
Brings up third down and 13.
The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. He'll look to throw. This is caught. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. A 16-yard touchdown as they are now on the board here in the first half.
I don't think it's any state secret to know what they were saying before the start of this drive. Let's go and punch one in the end zone and go into the halftime feeling a heck of a lot better about ourselves. Let's go get this done.
Yeah, tie things up, and then you get a brand new ball game. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
Here we go.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. Time here for likely one play, and then these two teams will head to the locker room all even.
And you know the play caller's just feeling it right now. Let's go ahead and go for this one. A big shot down. Nope. Guaranteed the head coach is like, don't get crazy. Take the knee. Let's get out of here. Tie game will just start all over.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Not wanting to take a chance this time, they'll keep it on the ground. And they're going to be waiting for him as they get him behind the line. And now they'll take a timeout defensively. After the second down play, they burn the timeout, making him sweat out the final few ticks here in the second quarter.
Ready, set. Rock it.
Once again, they'll keep it on the ground. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. So thanks to the late touchdown, it's a tie ball game here heading to break. As we send you up to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Set and ready to go for the second half. One touchdown apiece, 7-7 our score. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
Set.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. At the 28-yard line. The last run got three. Now here's second and seven.
Alpha!
Lock to throw on second down. Got his man there. It's Wallace complete. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. A Bronco first down there, 12 yards on the play.
Down. 60 outlaw. Man, man.
On first down, Lindsay. And the result here, a pickup of eight. Leaves him with two to go on second down.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. After the incompletion, here now, third and two. Third and two, Locke's going to throw. And that's knocked away and incomplete.
They went with the dive look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And now where will the side judge stop his walk? That's the question. He says it crossed out of bounds at about the 17-yard line. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. Their defense did its job, yielded no points. Now it's the offense's turn.
And how much fun is that when you set things up to start a half and you just tell you guys, hey, if you can shut them down, get it back for our offense, we can roll. And they played out perfectly. Now, can the offense do what they wanted to do at the half, which is find those weaknesses and now attack them and score some points.
And break this tie.
Ready.
Second and nine now. Quick hitter here, it's complete. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
That's a gain of four. Brings up third and five.
Here we go, set, 50, plant. Hey, zoom.
Where's 52? Watch 52. 52's the mic.
Here we go, here we go.
52's the mic, boy. 52.
Out of the gun now on third down. And he connects with Ertz. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks.
On the ready.
So first and 10 now from the 30.
Pilot, 64, weak.
Hey, hey, hey. Shift, watch the shift.
It goes.
They'll set up to throw. Now they go screen, it's complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. And even 30 yards on a play that began back at the 30.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, you know, excited about. But big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Here's a carry for a former starter. This is Lamar Miller. And the lane closes up quickly as he'll get about three down to the 38.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
60 or. Hey, rocket.
On second down now, it's Hunt. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
Set, ready? 10 logo.
54. Come on, baby. Let's see what you got.
Deep river.
They'll try to run for the first down with Hunt. And Hunt is not going to get there. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
And his kick is good. Oh, he just did tuck it into the bottom of that left corner. And the Dolphins have taken the lead. These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right? Baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
They'll start on the ground with Lindsey. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven.
Watch tight end. Tight end's right.
On play action. Lock. He's able to find Wallace. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A gain there of 30 big ones.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 42-yard line. Block now to throw. Looking sideline, incomplete. How about the defensive effort from both of these teams that we've seen in this game?
Would you say it's like a high-stakes chess match right now?
Chess is one way to go. Yeah, I like it.
Okay, the only reason I say that, you feel like they're contemplating their moves before actually making one, and none of them being done very confidently.
Truth be told, I've never played chess, and I know that I'm not smart enough to play chess. Guys like you with your IQ, you can pull that off. Denver has the first down to play going for 15 yards.
First down. Let's go, Denver. What you got, heavy?
Crystal, travel.
Throwing on first down is Locke. Throwing middle, and it's complete. Denver has a first down on the 15-yard play.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you get much more balance than this. Big-time run, big-time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
Back-to-back nice plays. 12 yards that time and a first down.
I hope we give enough respect to the big guys up front because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through and picking up first downs.
And he will take it in for a Bronco touchdown. Andy Janovich, his first touchdown on the year. And the Broncos have retaken the lead. And when the smaller guy can't power it across the goal line, Charles, sometimes you need to go with a fullback. They did. It worked.
What's that thing about force and mass? How's that?
Oh, yeah. Force equals mass times acceleration.
Oh, that's big-time stuff. That's from the same guy the apple dropped on his head, right?
Extra point from McManus is good. And the lead is now 14-10.
Brandon McManus to kick off for Denver.
after the touchdown. Here's McManus now to kick it away. This fielded at the two. And he will be taken down here on the return on what will wind up being the final play of this third quarter. Back now in Miami. It's Dolphin football, but they trail here as we get set for the fourth. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. This is Hunt. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. Give him 3 yards, and now they're left needing a conversion here on third and six.
On the set.
They're going to look to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A well-executed 22-yard gain.
Let's go, 50, plant.
Back to throw here. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. No gain on the screen there. It's second down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. On the run, this is Hunt. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. That one good for 13 and a Dolphin first down.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
On first down, they go right back to Hunt. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
Ready? 60 or 54. I got one.
Now a first carry for their fullback. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. If you're going to run against this unit, especially down here, just beware. I mean, they're the top rushing defense in the league.
Yeah, and then they go ahead and they double down with the whole thing because you think, okay, let's throw the ball. Oh, yeah, that's right. They defend the pass pretty well, too. Very difficult task right now.
Back to throw now on second and 10. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. Give him 6 on the play, and it'll be third down.
And the big guy catches the ball out of the backfield, and oftentimes it's quite a surprise to the guys playing defense because not ordinarily thought as a pass catcher, it often works when they decide to dial it up.
This a big play for both sides. What will we see here? Third and 4. On play action, they'll throw. Now the pressure gets there, and he goes down just inside the 20 at the 19. They've been moving the ball well offensively, really getting into a groove. Last play, pass completion. Now, finally, the defense gets there.
And you have to find a way to disrupt their rhythm. Do you do it with coverage, or do you do it with pressure? They elected to go with pressure, and it was the right call.
So with that field goal, this one's now back within a field goal. Maybe not the ultimate result they wanted, but gets them that much closer.
This game is unfolding like a really good book, isn't it? Because I feel like there's a few more plot twists yet to be revealed before this one is over.
And a penalty marker's down on the field. And they might be backing up a bit here to start the drive. So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on first and 10.
X3, 218, chopper. Ready, ready.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. So the face mask, quite a blessing there as they'll start out of harm's way with a first and 10. On first down, Locke. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in. I think you'd have to say defensively, these guys are doing their job pretty well, right?
Yeah, we talked about them holding them under 20 points, right, on defense. And they've done that. They've held them. The problem is their own offense hasn't answered their challenge, which was to score more.
Yeah, exactly. I remember you saying magic number was right around 20, and the offense has been the issue. You're right. 23 yards the pickup there. Coming up to the line, and they will need to run another play here before the two-minute warning.
You got four.
Get it.
They'll run on first down. It's Lindsay, and he's going to be hemmed in and brought down right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Fourth quarter, 2 minutes on the clock, in a tight one-point game. So it's Bronco football as we get your reset here. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. Locke's throw caught by Sutton. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40.
Oh, yeah.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
Ready, ready.
The second down completion got him seven. Now here's third and three. Back to throw, Locke. He's got his tight end fan, and he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 27-yard line.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game. And not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10.
Hey. Four down, four down, four down.
Five.
They'll go jet sweep here with Sutton. So he got free of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout as they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game. On second down, it's Lindsay. Now the Dolphins will use the last of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. Play number seven now coming up on the drive, third and five. They'll go again with Lindsay. He's got the first down inside the 10. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. Philip Lindsay with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Broncos push further out in front. And now the offense is going to stay out there as the Broncos will go for 2. To throw is locked. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. One possession game, time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation? He's got a man, complete. That's good for 28 yards.
You ready?
Mike 5-4.
Hey, wahoo!
Shoot. They'll look to throw. And this one incomplete. So the clock stopped now with 20 seconds remaining. So he's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is he just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
Big play coming up. Here's 3rd and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 17 yards for the Dolphins there as they've got themselves a first down.
Ready.
Mike 5-4. Bring it.
Hey, Delta.
One final shot. They'll look to throw. And this is incomplete. So no miracles here on the final play. And this ball game is over. But, Charles, a one-score game. Down to the end we went. They had one final play in that one-score game. We all knew what was coming, the Hail Mary. They just couldn't get it done.
Wasn't exactly complicated, was it? We all knew, as you said, and go long and see if we can find someone open. They didn't get it done. Someone's happy. Someone is not.
So for the Broncos, that early momentum continues here as they move to 4-0, and they will head back home next week. Meanwhile, for the Dolphins, they'll fall back to 500 at 2-2. And fortunately for them, they'll have the early bye next week as they return to action in week 6. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
treacherous, I effortlessly show them skills. Yeah, they burst off the edge like I don't know no bill. See the pain deep in my eyes, they know it's real. Yeah, been this way right before the deal. Say this one for your photo real. Blessing after testing, I'ma show them skills. Hop out it, rep for your prom, where your poster, pop in your projects.